Sean Vigezzi is a 19-year-old photographer, born and raised in Manhattan. When he's not taking photos of his underground exploits, he can be found working for Annie Leibovitz and Ryan McGinley.
Climbed onto this old boat called the Peking in the seaport. It's a huge boat. The woman front, he gets large, now she wants. Let's look in on the story as this man's telling this girl about herself. Yeah. See, girl, you look stupid now. And I gotta tell you something straight in your face. You played yourself like a big time toy from Mattel. You're trying to fund a little bit of what you got. Why don't you go on over there and let them dish you again? See your girlfriend's laughing and looking at me at the same time. Right,
Sean agreed to take us to a spot that he's fond of, an abandoned cellar in the heart of the city.
When did you first find this place?
I first found it when I was with my friend. I first found it when I was with my friend Zach and my friend Chris. And we were wandering around one night, it was freezing cold, it was last winter, and we had some paint on us, and we were like doing, well, they were doing a little bit of graffiti, and I guess when you're doing graffiti, you just kind of like walk everywhere, you don't really have like a goal in mind, like a set plan, you just wander. And right in front of the entrance to a train station, there was a Poland spring truck with those big gallons of water. And the driver wasn't there. He was like doing a delivery, even though it was like 5 a.m. And we pulled one of those gallons of water out of his truck, and we ran into a subway station with it. And we were like really dehydrated and really sharing this water. And there's a tunnel in this neighborhood that I always walk, like forever. Like I used to walk it since I was like 13. And since like I didn't really have like a goal in mind. I was just like, yo, whatever. Like let's just walk the tunnel. We walked off the platform into the tunnel, and I never paid attention, to these rooms off to the side of the tunnel. And I just walked straight to the next station, and I found a room with a set of staircases that led up into this space that I had never seen before. And there was always a lock on it. And one day, the lock was gone. So I guess a construction worker forgot to lock this place up, and I came up here. And there was no lights, and we all had our cell phones, and we were all falling like through all these pits, like getting really dirty, but we were just like so hyped that we found something new, so we kept going. And one of my friends found a light switch and flipped it, and the space just transformed. Like we had no idea how big the ceilings were or anything. Like your cell phone light only penetrates like 3 feet ahead of you. And we turn on the lights and we're like, holy shit. And I've been wanting to get underneath here forever. And, you know, with the whole post 9/11 security thing, it's impossible to get anywhere near the Brooklyn Bridge. Like, if you take pictures while you're, like, walking on it and a cop sees you, they'll ask you, like, they'll kind of hassle you. So to be in here is, like, an honor. Like, it's just so cool. This is as light as the subway tunnel ever gets.
Why subway tunnels?
I feel that subway tunnels are the most fun places to explore in New York City because, obviously it's the feeling of like being underneath the biggest, greatest, most famous city in the world. It's just like you could be walking in subway tunnels underneath Times Square and you're just like, you know that like right above you, just a couple feet above you lies like the real world. And you're just in this weird purgatory space underneath the street where like nothing matters and like no one can hear you, no one knows you're there. And it's like this eerie, empowering, it's eerie, but it's also like this really empowering feeling of being like, I'm underneath New York City, like, no one's probably been here before. The last time someone was here was like so long ago, and it's just really exciting. And you never know what you're gonna find. And you know, you get to see like relics of the city that no one's seen. And like, when you go to a space like this, honestly, you can count on your fucking hands how many people have been here, like who's been here. Do you think like the everyday person, every Joe Schmo that walks around, that works right above us in the municipal building, that works in City Hall, do you think they've ever been down here? Like, no. It's the MTA workers, it's me, it's you, and maybe a bunch of other people. But like, you can count on your hands, I'm sure. So it's like underground spaces are the most fascinating because it's just like they have history to them and like, the city's so different than I remember when I was growing up, but the subway tunnels are timeless. Like, they're just like, time doesn't drastically affect them. I mean, the amount of trash in subway tunnels will build up over the years, but the structure won't change. You know, it's just like, it stays the same, and it's crazy. Like, you're walking in these tunnels and you're just like, I don't know, you could like play with your imagination and like role play and be like, I'm an explorer, or like, I don't know, you just like get in this like mindset of like, you feel like really like, I don't know, like important, because like you're underneath like this big ass city, and it's just like, I don't know, I can go on forever about it, honestly. Look more interesting from below.